Hi, I'm Christoph from Berlin, Germany, and I work for KDAB. And in this series, I'm talking about how to speed up your day-to-day development life in embedded. Today, we are going to talk about hot reload in QML. Nowadays, Qt embedded applications are mostly developed in QML. The reasons are: most embedded UI projects require touchscreens nowadays, and QML brings the touch mindset to UI programming more than Qt widgets does. First, elements are already multi-touch enabled. Second, it does not dictate a predefined look and feel and allows for customization. Most of our developers are able to define UIs very rapidly using QML's simple structure. Lastly, it integrates with OpenGL, with Qt 6 also with Vulkan, as well as with software rendering for optimal performance. QML itself can be executed as an interpreted language. That means you do not need to compile. Individual files can be live reloaded. What enables us to do this inside QML is the loader element. It's basically an empty frame that can show the contents of a QML file. We can change just the QML file and reload the loader while the application is still running, and this is allowed. My colleague Jesper did a video just on the loader, and you will find the link in the description. Like in the last video, we want to be quick in our development cycle here. That means we develop, we find a mistake, we fix the mistake, and then we repeat. It would be really nice to see the changes right away, revealing the latest status on the embedded touchscreens right away.
Okay, so here we are in our code. As you can see, I have now added a color slider to my code, which I want to change throughout the part of this video. So I will first go to my terminal and enable the syncing between both, such that every time I change something here in QML, it will be synced over, and the hot reload will make sure that it's automatically reloaded on the other side. So the first thing I want to change is to move the slider to the right side. So I can say anchors.right is parent.right. Nothing happens, but when I press the save button, you will see that the slider actually moves to the right. You will see it's also still a working application. I can set the proper color, and it's still all working without actually restarting the application. Maybe next I want to have a default value. This value might be like in the middle of the slider, 0.5. And as you can see, I pressed save, and my slider now moved to the middle as the default value. I see it's not really aligned, so I think the vertical alignment is not correct here. What I can do is just, again, set the anchors of this, anchors.vertical center is parent vertical center. And again, I press save, and you will see the slider moving up. It's still working.
In this demo, I did exactly this. I used the loader to hot reload the main scene on my screen. I connected it to a reload mechanism, and when I edit something on my desktop and press save, the application changes instantly without restarting. In this case, the designer asked me to position the slider from the left to the right of the screen. I will go to my Qt creator, make the according changes in the layout, and when I save, the file is automatically sent over via rsync and libnotify. The UI instantly shows the new layout, which I can directly discuss with my designer. While doing this, I learned the hard way that QML keeps a component cache of every old component, which makes this kind of trick hard to pull off. When loading a component inside a loader, which has the same name as the component that was loaded before, QML will use a cache. So when I first tried to reload my file, everything still stayed and looked the same, which was bad. So after quite some searching, I found that I needed to clear the QML component cache in the QML application engine. When triggering this clear, in addition to the reloading, the overall reloading just works as expected. But you might ask, isn't there a QML compiler? QML nowadays is often compiled pre-packed to allow for a quicker startup, but in our demo case, the compiler was needed to be turned off to allow for the live reload. When you ship your final product, make sure to turn the compiler back on. But until then, hot reload helps you as the developers to be quick. This trick is not new. Many projects I have worked on have incorporated some sort of live reloading. Advanced reloaders, like the commercial one available from Felgo, can even reload during typing. Want to see that in action? Check out this short video. If you're interested on how they do it, there's a longer talk on our Qt DevCon recordings right here. I hope you can also profit from applying this trick to your project to save you time. You can find all the code I used in the description below. If you would like to be informed about more of such improvements, just subscribe. I hope you enjoyed this video. See you next time. Und auf Wiedersehen und bis bald.